connected, but first to news that is rapidly breaking as we go to air. Former US President Donald Trump is being investigated for espionage after removing classified documents from the White House. Alison Petrowski is in Los Angeles following this developing story this morning. Ali, good morning. The judge has just unsealed that search warrant.
Yeah, in the last hour or so, Charles, good morning to you. The Florida judge unsealing not only the search warrant, but also the property receipt from the raid on Donald Trump's Mar-a-Lago home earlier this week. Donald Trump did not object to it. And look, we are starting, Charles, to get a much clearer picture of the FBI's investigation into Donald Trump. 27 boxes were taken from Mar-a-Lago the other day. Inside them, 11 sets of classified documents, some with the highest level of top secret classification, binders of photos, a handwritten note, an executive grant of clemency for his ally, Roger Stone, and information about the French president. Now, no specific detail, Charles, on what was in those classified documents for obvious reasons, although the Washington Post did reveal yesterday that they believe it's in relation to nuclear weapons. But it is the search warrant that reveals that Donald Trump is being investigated by the FBI for a potential violation of the Espionage Act, as well as the removal and destruction of records, and obstructing an investigation. Now, look, Charles, at the beginning of this week, there was a lot of talk about if he was being investigated on a technicality. Had he been in a dispute with the National Archives and just taken some presidential records home and left them in the bottom of the basement at Mar-a-Lago? The Republican Party, as you know, have been up in arms saying that this was a politically motivated attack. But look, this search warrant shows that this investigation is far more significant and is far more serious. It is early days. Donald Trump has not been charged. This is an active investigation. But look, a conviction on these matters would result in imprisonment. It would result in a hefty fine. And look, I'm probably stating the obvious here, Charles, but he certainly would not be able to run for president ever again.
Yeah, big consequences ahead, Ali. Thank you. Back now this Saturday morning with breaking details on the FBI raid on Donald Trump's Mar-a-Lago property, with the search warrant released this morning. The warrant revealing the former president is under investigation for espionage. US studies expert and professor at Sydney University, Simon Jackman, joins us now. G'day, Simon. Good to have you again. Look, espionage is a huge word. It's probably a little bit deceiving here. This is largely about keeping and storing documents that allegedly shouldn't have been there. What happens, though, if the president is charged here?
Look, it's Donald Trump, and we're in such uncharted territory, Charles. Like, no former president has had his residence searched. Mm. No former president has been this pointedly at the subject of a criminal investigation. And as much as this is a legal matter and the wheels of US justice are grinding on, it is also a political matter. Mm. And the costs, in a broader sense of the term, of prosecuting Donald Trump. Again, that's uncharted territory too, but it's hard to see at this point how we don't keep going down the road towards Donald Trump being indicted.
And that has huge impacts, obviously, for some pretty fractious fault lines in America.
Absolutely.
Right now, but also the 2024 presidential election. It strikes me that if the Department of Justice mm-hmm. is going this hard on a former president, mm-hmm. they'd want to have their ducks in a row,
yeah,
right?
Great point, Charles. And I think we saw that aspect of this in, you know, in vivid demonstration of how carefully the US Department of Justice went. They weren't going after lost laundry yeah. tickets or anything like this. The fact that, and they've come out with the details of what Trump had in his possession, and they're pretty remarkable sort of documents. We're not talking about even personal documents of the president. We're talking about things at extraordinarily high levels of classification. And that, I don't think they can't help but now go all the way towards indictment. But it just underscores the seriousness of this. When they're not going to do this lightly, and I think they were under real pressure, as we all know, over the last couple of days, to demonstrate just how serious this yeah. was. I think they're now over that hurdle.
You mentioned the details. The new report claims they recovered 11 sets of classified documents. Do we have a clear picture of exactly what's in these documents?
No, we won't, because of their classification. Intriguingly, there's a reference to the president of France. There are, you know, they've sort of gone into that level of detail, indicating sort of the general topic. But those words, top secret, and the idea that some of them are sort of at top secret, but only to be viewed in a SCIF, a secure compartment yeah. information environment, that indicates, again, they're top secret plus. And some of the leaking coming out of Washington over the last couple of days has alluded to, they pertain to the nuclear weapons yeah. arsenal of the United States of America. And at that point, wow, yeah. Like, we are talking extraordinarily sensitive documents, and there is no way a former president or anybody should have that anywhere other than in a concrete bunker somewhere.
There has been ramifications for the FBI. We saw that overnight. I mean, this is a very divided nation. Where does this go from here?
And that's what I was alluding to at the top there, Charles, about the political environment to which this is playing in. I think one of the big questions in North America this summer has been, look, more and more evidence is starting to mount, either with January 6th or, as it turns out, keeping these documents that he's not meant to have, that Trump is engaged in criminal activity. OK, fine, but are you really going to cross over and prosecute a guy who won 47% of the vote, who got 60, 70 million-odd votes at the last election, whose supporters are as mad as hell and occasionally, as Jan 6 revealed, are prepared to get on the streets and be violent?
Yeah.
And I think that's been the big question. And where we've landed, well, what happens if you don't prosecute someone like that? In what sense do you still get to call yourself a democracy? And I think both Joe Biden has kept these distance from Merrick Garland, who's one of the heroes of this story so far, and that no man or woman is above the law in the United States. And I think that's what this episode is all about fundamentally.
And it is just an episode. There is plenty more to come, that's for sure.
There is plenty more to come, Charles.
Great having you on the show this morning.
A pleasure. Thank you.